feel like those guys are progressing, particularly Rivera and Downs? Or are they where you thought they would be here 7 games in, I guess?
I'm happy with Mike. I mean, you know, he showed up with a big play the other night, and you know, he gives you good effort in the run game. Sometimes he gets overwhelmed by defensive ends and bigger 3-4 outside backers, but you know, he fights, and that's about what you need to have out of a tight end. Downs brings you a little more weight, a little more heavy-handedness in the blocking game. You know, he's rough in the pass protection area, and we constantly work on that. And you know, he's still fighting through that knee a little bit, but he's ready when it comes Saturday, and that's what matters.
And you're obviously the special teams guy, so you teach CP all his moves back there on the returns?
That's it. Yeah, every one of them. And we talked about this all the way back to the very beginning when I got here. You know, returners make you special. Players make you special. And he's special. And so, you know, we like to get the ball in his hands. Now, I do want to, you know, we looked at it, and sometimes you look and you think, like, wow, CP made 5 people miss, and that's all that happened. But if you look, particularly on kickoff returns, you see a lot of people on the ground. And there were a lot of people working for him. A lot of people got their people down. There were some people that missed their blocks, got up, and got at the end of the play. And so that's the way it always is. We got a lot of people working hard for him. But I will also say this. It gets you excited about working when you know you got a cat back there that can make people miss.
Yeah, when there's this guy like CP back there returning kicks for you, you think it leads into the rest of the team where guys are wanting to be on those units and block for him?
No question. Other people want to block for him. I want to coach for him. You know, we want to find a way to get air for him because guy makes things happen, and you know, he's done a good job. And so, yeah, there's no question that there's a little bit of electricity. You know, when you go on the field, you know he's going to handle it.
You've been in the league, you've had a long career. Does he remind you of anyone else that you've seen? Or?
Yeah, he reminds me of a couple of them. He's special. I mean, if CP learns how to work and do all the right things, he's got a special career ahead of him. And, you know, he's reminds me of a young Randy Moss. That's a big statement. He's not Randy Moss yet or anything like that, but he reminds me a little bit of him.
Coach, you probably asked us a little bit earlier about Ace Sanders. How do you slow down a guy like Ace Sanders? Do you try and kick away from him? What do you do because he's such a weapon, he's so dangerous.
He is. I mean, it's just like the one we were just talking about. And we've addressed it as such. You know, I'm not going to talk a lot about how we're going to try to stop him, but he's you know, he puts that foot in the ground, and I mean, he just makes people look silly. And then he'll go down, and he's got a little wiggle about him. So we've got our hands full, and we've taken great pride in our kickoff unit and our punt unit. You know, we think they're getting better each week. We had a punt get away from us a little bit last week, but you know, we're taking a lot of pride in that. But you understand, it's almost like tight ends every week. You know, you got a really good outside back or a defensive end to block. Well, it's almost like when you cover in the SEC, same thing. We've got another great one, but I will say this: I have not seen anybody in the league better than Ace Sanders. So we better come to work.